Hey guys, Coupon Slayer. This is my Uncle Jeremy, and he's really cool. I wanted to talk about the Darling Llama. So, first question. How cool is he? I bet he's really cool.
The coolest. He's cool. Really mellow. He stays calm. He's just always got that smile on his face. He's everything you expect and more. He's the coolest.
Now, would you say he's a really good role model?
Very good role model. He's leading the world to peace. His whole philosophy is about the world coming together, regardless of creed, color, race, what culture, background you are, your parts of the mind, love, peace, and bringing the world together.
Everybody should be like him, guys. Like, that just sounds like picture perfect. And yeah. Next question. What part of the country did you like the most?
When I was in India, I met the Dalai Lama in the Himalayas, and that's one of the most beautiful sceneries, one of the best parts of the country I've ever been in. There's lots to it. There's where the Taj Mahal is, there's nice beaches, but honestly, where he was, it's the most spiritual place I've felt. Most of home away from home.
I bet you got to see really cool mountains.
Some really cool mountains, met some really nice people, met some really inspirational people. You said it's never done on our own. I love Calcutta, but to me, that was great. She was an inspiration. Now, he's from a Buddhist background, and she's from a Catholic background. So the reason I like you both, the equal reason, regardless of religion or faith, it's that love, bring the world together, bring peace together. If you want this world to succeed, then everyone's got to give, to educate. Now, I'm on this famous story, Mother Teresa. As inspiration people go, that's the lesson of life for the Bible. And if you take the word, it's going to go in your mind again, but that giving spirit, a leading life to go like that, is good.
That's cool that you got to meet her too. I didn't know that, actually.
I met her in Calcutta about a year before she passed away.
No. Yeah.
Funny story about Mother Teresa. I was at Mother Teresa house. I was too sick to work. I went there to volunteer. And after everybody left, I looked and I saw where Mother Teresa would be leaving from, because she was about to leave Calcutta to go to a flight out of the country. So I waited around and I met her. She was so nice, so kind. She didn't tell me about herself, she asked about me, she asked about my family, she asked about all the things that might make me back
home.
She excused herself because she was running late for the flight. And before she left, she remembered every male member in my family, every female member in my family. She gave me a rosary for every lady that was relevant to me and my family, and a little business card with her name. Mother Teresa saying that every male member of my family, and she was giving me each one of them, she remembered everyone by name, and she was the same as Dalai Lama. When you meet them, you know that they're genuine and they come from a place where God's got the experience.
Amen to that. Amen to that. Let me think. I have one more question. Okay, so, what was the best thing about the Dalai Lama? That he just accepted everybody and that he was a good person?
And he come across as a true leader. But a true leader doesn't have to be with a loud voice, with threats of violence, with ulterior motives. A true leader, you can tell, comes from
love
you. And now he come across as someone that is a good example for anybody that is thinking about being a leading example, giving inspiration to somebody. Then we've got to have his mindset in my mind. That the only way that this world is going to be wrong is to ignore all the things that divide us and concentrate on all the things that we have in common, all the common problems we have, common solutions for those problems, and do it not with violence, not with aggression, not with a loud voice, but follow the Dalai Lama's example, God rest his soul, Mother Fraser's example, and Mother Fraser is following writing Jesus' whether you're a Jesus believer or not, and the Dalai Lama is following right in the Buddhist book, if you're a Buddhist or not. They come from the same ideal, they have a different belief in a higher power, but they're coming from that same central idea that the only way that this earth is going to get on is if this earth wants to get on in peace and cooperation. That I don't know is a very good example of that. So you've got to be able to watch any video of him, any interview he's ever been in, and you'll see that philosophy coming through. But if he's heard me on, take someone like him, take the role of him.
And my Drugarit teacher actually said ELE, and ELE stands for Everybody Watch Everybody. And that basically leads on to what you're saying. And it's true. I mean, you should. I mean, you know, I know a lot of people don't like each other, but if you have the sense of goodness and kindness, then you could try to change that and make the world a better place. But anyway, guys, that's pretty much it. If you could, please slap a like on this video, comment down below, subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell notification. It will do some good because it lets you know that you enjoy my videos and enjoy videos like this.
Thank you, Sly.
Thank you. All right, and if you could, one more question. Can you say peace out?
Peace out.
Peace out and quick wrap. All right, that's pretty much it, guys, and I will catch you guys later. Thank you for watching this video, and goodbye.